We must fund our allies in these foreign wars, because if our allies do not win, then the enemies will come to us and we will have wars to deal with. We can prevent our own wars by funding our allies. But the people of Great Britain have figured out that Charles is lying to them. He is not funding their allies, he is funding their enemies. Because the enemies want to help Charles take control of Great Britain. Charles is brought up on charges of treason, found guilty and sentenced to death. A process that gives us the fourth document in the genealogy of our Constitution. It's called the Grand Remonstrance of 1641. Now remember, Dick Durbin wants you to think that we're intellectually superior to these people. But this Grand Remonstrance of 1641 is an amazing document. It says, the root of all this mischief we find to be a malignant and pernicious design, subverting the fundamental laws and liberties of our kingdom. Put that in modern English, they're basically saying, hey, wait a minute now, we've been watching tyrants for 600 years, and we're starting to notice a pattern. The same bag of tricks over and over again, a wicked, evil plan whose only purpose is to overturn and undermine liberty. That wicked, evil plan they identify is corruption of the court system, infiltration of foreign law, diminishing property rights of the people, the government taking control over the church to control the people, creation of fiat money to manipulate the economy, and disarming the people while the government remained armed. Think we're smarter than we were back then? Because I'm thinking we wouldn't be repeating that mistake if we knew it. Do you think this is the last time they're going to have to fight? 40 years later, they have a new king. His name is James II. James II is engaging in the entire malignant and pernicious design all over again. Only James has learned that if you're going to take the liberty of the people, you have to give them something in return. He issues a decree that establishes a type of religious liberty. This religious liberty decree says you no longer have to be a member of the Church of England. You can have church anywhere you want, with any pastor you want, you can preach anything you want, and the church cannot prosecute you. But, the decree says, before you have church, you must inform the king where you'll be meeting, when you'll be meeting,